this episode too, I will be generating 12 volts from a car alternator through battery excitation. Now, this is a Valeo manufactured 12 volts 90 amps car alternator.
And for battery excitation?
We will need a 12 volts battery of any size. This battery is actually for powering up the rotor or field winding. And this rotor is available in all types of car alternators. Now, at the back of the alternator, there is this rectangular plastic casing on which these two pinouts that you see are for feeding electricity to the rotor, which means the battery wires will be connected here. So, let's solder two wires here as red and black. And now, let's test it. So, as you can see, it is working. Therefore, let's take a paper tape, write down 12 volts DC input, tear it, and place it on these wires. Now, take the 12 volts battery and connect the red wire from the alternator to the positive of the battery. Similarly, the black wire to the negative of the battery. Next, take a DC clamp meter and set it to the lowest DC current measurement mode, which is 60 amperes in my case. Now clamp this meter to one of the two wires. The meter is flashing 4.6 amperes. So let's note it down for power loss calculations.
Now this is the current that we are feeding the alternator right now, and we are not getting any electricity from it.
So the power loss is battery voltage, which is 13.2 volts DC, multiplied by current that is 4.6 amperes, making it 61 watts, which is huge,
as it is equivalent to the power rating of many appliances that we use in our day-to-day lives. Example,
phone chargers, soldering iron, printers, etc. So anyways, let's disconnect the battery and move on to the part of how to connect the output wires to the alternator.
Now, the output amperes from a car alternator are very high and dangerous, so thick wires are highly recommended.
Now, at the back of the alternator, there is this screw which is longer than the others. That's the main positive output. So let's connect our red wire to this one. There is an announcement. I've started these daily quizzes to refresh your knowledge on the basics. Find them in the community posts. Finally, the full body of the alternator is going to be your overall negative. So choose a point and connect your black wire there. Please note, for level 2 quizzes, exclusive videos and faster comment replies, join channel membership now. Time for power generation testing. So, take a multimeter and point it to the DC voltage measurement mode. Next, connect the meter wires to the alternator output wires. Next, reconnect the battery to the rotor. And so, our alternator is ready to produce huge electricity. So, if we turn the pulley of the alternator, you can see some generated voltage displayed on the meter screen. Let's see what the max we can do with simple hand rotation.
5.9 volts. 6.3 volts. Good. 6.56 volts. That is huge. So let's check the maximum voltage we can produce through rope rotation. And go. Whoa. 16 volts DC output. Now, let's use this bulb as load for the alternator. It's a car headlamp incandescent bulb, 12 volts. Okay, go! Working great as expected. Now, let's use this clamp meter to measure the short circuit current through rope rotation testing. Okay, go! It gets really tight to rotate under short circuit conditions. So, a befitting example for the free energy content creators and believers.
So, here I have installed my alternator on this vise, and to the pulley of the alternator, I have connected this belt. So, starting with the voltage measurement, this is voltage and we have 0 volts here. So, let's connect the meter wires to the output of the alternator. Positive to positive, negative to negative. And now it is time to connect the battery wires to the alternator, black to black and red to red.
So all the connections are complete and now it is time to start the test.
Okay, go. So here you can see that it is already generating 17.5 volts DC and this is the lowest RPM that I can give to my alternator. Let's increase it and see how much more we can generate. Now let's connect this bulb and see how much it glows. Nice, let's turn off the lights. So bright.
So here are a few bulbs from cars and motorcycles that I've connected for testing them with my car alternator.
Next, I'm going to use this spring for short circuit testing of this alternator. So this spring is going to be connected to the output cables. And yes, the pulley is quite hot because of the slippage and friction. So I want to try one last thing, that is adding one more belt in parallel to this pulley. And let's hope for positive results then. Whoa, 25 amperes. Now let's increase the speed for a short duration and go. 30 amps. Wow. Whoa. There was so much torque needed to run this alternator because of which it was coming out from the vise and this spring got damaged because of the high temperature. That's it. The great news is that from now on, this channel is going to be strictly dedicated to the alternator and generator videos with all of its content in English plus subtitles in different languages. Also, in total, I have three channels now. The first one is my main Mr. Electron channel. The second one is the Mr. Electron alternator channel, which is this one. And the third one is my Mr. Electron Hindi channel that I have just started. On top of all this, I've also launched my Patreon's membership page, which means that from now on, if you have queries or you want to take a deeper dive into the topic that I cover through my videos, then this page is for you. So make sure that you check out its membership box. So that's all for today. See you next time.